Saturday, 19th of October. So count
the chair.
What's that?
Turn around.
Sorry. Saturday, 19th of October. So Cal Pro. Simon Miller is headed to California, where I am gonna take on the Pecosaurus Rex, Anthony Idol. I'll let you in into a little bit of a secret. I'm just a tiny bit worried. I mean, number one, he is from Idlefornia, and I don't even know where that is, and I looked on a map. I mean, there's no Millerstown, there's no Millersville, so he's already got that one on me. Number two, he calls himself the Neon Phenomenon, and as we all know, neon is the best color. Number three, the man even has me when it comes to social media, because he went out there and he learned what it was all about.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel.
First of all, why didn't anybody ever tell me? Come here for a minute.
So I am totally boned. So instead, what I've decided to do is kill you with kindness. So Anthony, you are the greatest professional wrestler in the history of this sport. And I'm sorry that I have to try and beat you so bad that I can use all of my weight and pressurize that onto your shoulders in order to keep you on the mat for the 1-2-3. Also, please do forgive me, Anthony, when I try and hit you with a spear, because the intent of that is to crush your ribs so you can barely breathe. That's just disgusting. But I can also not apologize enough for using the ringside lights to blind you, courtesy of my bald head. To be honest, that's not something I planned to do. It's just something that happens. You've got hair as well. I am doomed. This Saturday though, Idol, is you versus me in a winner takes all match. What I mean by that is the money, the power, the pride, and this tripod, because I don't want to take it home on the plane with me. You've seen baggage costs these days. It's out of control. So you get ready, Anthony, because Miller is coming to California and he's gonna give you everything he's got. No, I don't really know what that means.
So we need to roll on, as today's main event will be a 25-man over-the-top battle royal match. That plus contest, candy, prizes, raffle, you name it, all that and more, including the following contest scheduled for one fall.
Thank you.
The following contest is for the SoCal Pro Tag Team Championship! Introducing first the challengers from your Highness Casa, weighing in at 344 pounds, Don Caliente, Gustavo Perez, Dos Caliente! At a total combined weight of 383 pounds, they are the hottest tag team in the mundo, and your SoCal Pro Tag Team Champions, LA Bando, the Lucha
here with my Navy dude. Well, I'm ready to wish anchors away to this competition, my guy.
The Lucha Kings making their return here to SoCal Pro. People loving, absolutely loving the Lucha Kings. You can barely hear yourself talk or even think here.
What?
Yeah, exactly.
Tuesday. Now, dudes, Lucha Kings have been setting the house on fire every single time they're here. It's no wonder they're a fan favorite. But are they hot enough to handle two Caliente?
Dos Caliente definitely making their having their work cut out for them here. If they can pull this off as a brand new tag team in professional wrestling here at SoCal Pro, in fact, in Southern California in general, they could bring about one of the biggest upsets that we have seen here as becoming a brand new set of tag team champions.
And what a moment if they are able to pull it out and climb that mountain in their debut match.
A little bit of dancing here to maybe frustrate El Rey of the Lucha Kings as Bamboo pulls him close, telling him not to fall in for the dirty tricks. Missing with the right hand, again blocked with the right hand, chop onto El Rey as Don Caliente ascends up to the top rope. What are we gonna see here?
Oh, Oh, walking the tightrope. Oh! And that's the danger of going up top, my dude. High risk, high reward, but also high level of failure if you do.
And thankfully, Don Caliente is okay, did not hurt his neck. As we continue on with this match, El Rey now with the headlock, the side headlock to Don Caliente. Don Caliente, again, not necessarily the more experienced one of the two. As you can tell, El Rey now just driving that shoulder down to Don Caliente. And the crowd seems to think that El Rey might be a little bit more Caliente than Don Caliente right now.
Well, he's definitely a house of fire, my dude. There's no doubt about that.
Messing with the line. Out comes back to El Rey. Big crossbody. Again, messing with the line. Another line missed. Double drop kick. Nobody connected. Back to their feet. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to SoCal Pro Wrestling. And this is just a sliver of what's to come. Charlie Gnar, you know as well as anybody knows, there is some amazing action still here to come. Yet another championship is on the line as Matthias takes on our current reigning champion is the Mighty Tortuga.
The Mighty Tortuga, indeed. That is going to be a battle. Not just a battle, a war, my dude. Last man standing. Matthias is one ass-kicking machine, but I don't know. Tortuga, that's one tough turtle.
One turf till indeed. In fact, it should be noted that the Mighty Tortuga is the current POW MIA champion of another professional wrestling organization in Hesperia, California called Valor Pro Wrestling. Big shout out to them as he represents them coming down here. But now let's get back to the action. As a big runner takes down Bamboo.
And there's that experience you were talking about, Gustavo, the more experience of the two of those Caliente. And dude, he is showing that he lives up to the name.
Lives up to the name indeed, as we are getting a bunch of near falls or near misses here. Again, missing that big line is Bamboo back to the cover. Nobody, no one count there. And maybe one, not even a one count there, as both are back to their feet. Ladies and gentlemen, Halloween Heat continues as the Heat ranks up here at SoCal Pro. Unbelievable.
Dude, it's hot in here, dude. It's the heat, but it's also just electric in this building.
Electric in this building. You can feel it. You can cut the tension with a knife. That is for sure. And now, once again, big drop kick to the knees of Gustavo, as perhaps Bamboo now taking advantage. Oh, my goodness. What would you even call that, Charlie?
I call that a big old sit and a big old hurt.
As now just getting the narrow two count. As Gustavo Perez is perhaps getting some supporters, that going towards Bamboo is now tagged in to El Rey coming back in as Lucha Kings, the more experience of the two teams working together. What are we going to see here? Caught on the ropes, back down as Gustavo Perez takes a face first and a big side kick to the face as now Gustavo Perez is in an unfavorable position. El Rey down with a big splash. Bamboo follows it with a big splash of his own. Back to the cover, one, two.
And that's the danger of facing the Lucha Kings. They come out of you from all angles. They'll come at you, dude. It doesn't matter where you're looking. There's going to be a body flying at you.
They are seasoned, to say the least. The Lucha Kings are the SoCal Pro Tag Team Champions for a very good reason, as now El Rey going up to the top rope, going back down, but caught with Gustavo Perez. Big side kick to the face. As Gustavo Perez now takes control, tagging in Don Caliente. European uppercut. Here's a snap bear by Caliente, sizing this man up. What are we going to see here? Perhaps a double team move.
El Rey disoriented, discombobulated, and now de-chestified from those kicks.
De-chestified, I like that. Count of two now. Only a count of two. You're not going to put away the Lucha Kings that easily. Again, they are the tag team champions for a reason. As Caliente works El Rey back to the corner, maybe shooting off to the other buckle here. Up and over goes El Rey. Big somersault. El Rey comes in. Missed line there by Don Caliente. Big crossbody. El Rey now back with another cover. Two. And you may want to find out, you may want to notate that perhaps each count is getting just a little bit closer to that three, that impeccable three count that will determine the ending of this match, as the Lucha Kings definitely want to bring this championship reign home with them to back to Tijuana, Mexico.
Oh, dude, don't worry. I'm taking studious notes today.
Studious indeed is Bamboo now with the cover. One, two. Grabbing the rope, and you don't necessarily see this from Don Caliente. Dos Caliente in general don't necessarily do that. They usually kick out. They have a tremendous amount of fire in them, but I think the absolute travesty of this match, this absolute fire of a match, is definitely taking a lot out of this poor young man.
If you were in the ring with them, would you have the power to kick out when you've been taking the punishment that Dos Caliente has? They're going to do whatever it takes because... I'm sorry, I can't even hear myself think. Oh!
That might be whatever it takes. Is Don Caliente now taking in another tag? Sizing him up now with the camel clutch. Big side boot to the face. That might be enough to put him away here. We might have new tag team champions. One, two, only two. Again, we are getting closer even to the three count on the side of Dos Caliente as well.
It's going to be a night of battles, wearing down your opponent. That's the name of the game.
Blocked the chop. Took that one all. Gave him one of his own. As Bamboo and... Oh, here we go. This is an epic chop bottle. Oh, my goodness. That just sounds horrible.
You know, my dude, it's not often that you... stand there and let the person chop you, but at this point, it's not about winning, it's about pride. Who can take more punishment? And dude, they're gonna find out. Oh, I'll be quiet.
Not quite as powerful.
He got all of that one.
Moving the hair around now. Shh. Nasty as Gustavo now taking his second fall to the floor from that chop. That is just brutal, the Lucha Kings. But look, at the heart of this young man, coming in, maybe not even getting all of it, but nonetheless, he is very much trying with that heart. Block, and another block, a double kick to the chest as both men get sent back. Total combined, kangaroo dropkick sends Gustavo into the corner. In comes Don Caliente, missing the elbow, missing another elbow by El Rey, missing the dropkick, or missing the, miss. There's so many misses. Both teams gotta be so frustrated by now.
I mean, it just goes to show why the Lucha Kings are the SoCal Pro Tag Team Champions and why Dos Caliente have gotten this chance. Both teams, all four athletes, are at the height of their game. Speaking of height, from the drop kicks there.
Double drop kick now sending both of Dos Caliente back to the buckle, but obviously pulling back as they now get sent back out to the outside. The Lucha Kings, what are we gonna see here? Watch out now, we might go airborne. No, big old cutoff by Dos Caliente. This is their opportunity to capitalize. We might see new tag team champions. No, back to reversal. The reverse Uno card as both men get sent back out to the outside. Where were we before we got rudely interrupted? It's Air Lucha King time.
Air Lucha Kings, and they got a front row seat, my dude. First class.
If you are not here, ladies and gentlemen, it is deafening. This crowd going absolutely insane as both Lucha Kings come out to the outside, destroying their opponents, showing everybody why they are the most dominating tag team in SoCal Pro here today.
Andrew, I didn't hear what you said, but it is deafening in this building right now.
Back to the action is now the Lucha Kings setting up as Don Caliente might be in a very unfavorable place, despite the fact that he is trying his best to punch his way out of it. Gustavo Perez now with a face kick. Oh my goodness, Don Caliente now in a good position. This could be it here. Beautiful double runners. Are we gonna see Caliente go up? Out they go!
Caliente!
And we are just getting started, Gnarly Trilly Gnar. There is so much more to come. Can you believe this is just the beginning of an incredible Halloween heat here at SoCal Pro in Vista?
You know, I'm gonna be honest with you. No, I cannot believe it. This is outstanding. This has exceeded all expectations already, and we're not even over the first match.
Could we be seeing an upset? As far as I was concerned, the Lucha Kings had this one in the bag. But now it could be anybody's match. This still could be Don Caliente's match, or Dos Caliente's match, as they send in El Rey for a double. Oh, no! Bamboo now catching the foot that that experience of the tag team. Again, it's back and forth, back and forth. All that's left is Bamboo and Don Caliente now.
El Rey back on his feet.
Up goes Don Caliente, down he goes, that could be it. Oh my goodness, as Gustavo Perez takes advantage. But here comes Bamboo to the double boots to the face.
The term throwing haymakers comes to mind.
Listen to this crowd, it is deafening here in Vista. You can't even hear yourself think.
What?
You can't even hear yourself think.
What?
You can't even hear yourself think.
I'm sorry, I can't hear myself think. This is too insane, too hot, too caliente. This is why SoCal Pro is awesome, my dude.
We may very well be seeing history in the making here, ladies and gentlemen, as Dos Caliente perhaps sealing the deal here. Who can get to their feet first? It might all come down to the final few seconds of this match. Both teams now making in a tag to the fresher person as Bamboo comes in. House of Fire, double clothesline now down to the mat as Don Caliente is helped to his feet by Perez. Up, back down to a double cutter. This could be the end here, this could be it. As the hope for Dos Caliente is quickly running out.
Indeed. This just shows what a well-oiled machine the Lucha Kings are, why they're champions, and I think why they may remain champions.
Remain indeed, this could be it here. One, two. Oh my goodness! It was all but over. It was all but over, Charlie Gnar.
Oh no, dude, that hand was coming down and he was not about to kick out. It's only because of his teammate that he was able to stay alive, and this match continues.
For how long is the question, as Don Caliente now back on top. Encouraging. Encouraging each other here.
Very confident Gustavo Perez shouting, it's over, and he may be right.
This might be it.
One, two, oh my, dude.
Two and three quarters. One of the closest matches I have ever seen, and we are just at the very beginning. The building is, you can't even see like 3 feet in front of your face. It's foggy from all the sweat, the heat that is going on here, the anticipation, the absolute craziness that is going on just from this one match alone, and to think we are only here getting started at SoCal Pro.
And you touched on something very important. I don't know if I've ever seen a match this close with the Lucha Kings. Dos Caliente are pushing them to their limit. This may be a challenge that the Lucha Kings can't overcome.
And well, what remains to be seen is the Lucha Kings now in an unfavorable position, but back to a favorable position as Dos Caliente might be back in trouble, as both men are now back to the opposite buckle. This is not a position you want to be in with the Lucha Kings. This could be it here. Splash, knee, kick, out they go. Cutters, that would be it. The Lucha Kings, that's gotta be it, Charlie.
Two, four, six.
Unbelievable.
Well, the SoCal Pro fans are vocal in their opinions, and they definitely have an opinion about that referee right now.
The referee catching the brunt of this as everybody in the audience wants to see a definitive winner. Drop toe holds now sends the Lucha Kings in trouble as Dos Caliente goes in. Opposite sides of the Butt Busters. Here they go for double suplexes, perhaps. Fisherman suplexes, down they go. Double cover,
two,
one,
four.
Unbelievable. Without a doubt, the most intense first match I have ever seen here in the history of SoCal Pro is taking place right in front of our eyes.
And that is an amazing statement coming from someone with such a history in tag team wrestling, such as yourself.
I appreciate that. I can't even, my voice is already shot. El Rey now taking the brunt of some punches as Don Caliente and Gustavo Perez
Already shot. We've got so many more matches this evening.
There's so much more to go.
No!
However, this could be the final point of this match as they get ready for the double suplex. No! Here comes Bamboo for the save. Oh, no. Are we going to see what I think we're going to see? Unbelievable!
What a power bomb.
Oh, now, oh, no. This is it. We've seen this one before. This could be the very end. Big cutter as Gustavo Perez doesn't even know where he is. Stick a fork in him. He's done.
Been knocked loopy.
Bamboo up and over.
Three. That's it. It's over. And still.
Here are your winners. And still. So.
Look at this maneuver that the Lucha Kings have used so many times, time and time again, to maintain their status as champion. And I'm going to be honest, I don't see their reign coming to an end anytime soon. They are at the top of their game. Truly the hottest in El Mundo are the Lucha Kings. Hard-fought victory, and now Dos Caliente entering the ring once more. And that's what it's all about, sportsmanship. We love to see it here at SoCal Pro Wrestling. That's what sets these competitors apart in their field.
I'll join the Rumble. Okay.
Yes! 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 I like the whole thing!
Can you imagine my fat ass in a stomp? I say retired for a reason.
Oh, come on, you look great!
Ladies and gentlemen, I do want to mention something very quick. There is a smaller wrestling organization just a few miles up the road in Hesperia, California, called Valor Pro Wrestling. The Mighty Tortuga, our very own The Mighty Tortuga, has become their very first POWMIA champion. So I do want to notate that as the Mighty Tortuga is a veteran, proudly served in the United States Marine Corps, so we just want to congratulate him on winning that. So later today, you may see him in with both belts. Make sure you let him know thank you for his service. He has definitely earned his right. Are you ready to continue on with some more Halloween Heat?
Thank you.
Jungle Walk Biggest Phenomenon! Weighing 304 pounds, the Neon Phenomenon, the Incredible Anthony Idol!
Bell has sounded. Ladies and gentlemen, we are into second match here at Halloween Heat. Oh my goodness, and what a way to start off that second match as the debuting Simon Miller comes into SoCal Pro, ready to put boots and to work to Anthony Idol.
Master of ups and downs, Anthony Idol is up and Simon Miller takes him down.
Simon Miller, definitely a grappler style wrestler, somebody who is very familiar with the route of old school Greco-Roman type wrestling, collegiate type wrestling, as Simon Miller is not one to play with. This is definitely going to be a unique challenge for the Neon Phenomenon.
Speaking of college, dude, Anthony Idol, no slouch either. All-American in college, dude. All-American football player, two-time conference champion. This is going to be a hard-hitting competition, just like Anthony's head hit hard on that mat.
I see what you did there, as Simon Miller, definitely a crowd favorite. Is he more popular than Anthony Idol, the Neon Phenomenon? That remains to be seen as he goes in for a cover early. Only a count of two, as the Neon Phenomenon definitely can't get put away that quickly in this contest.
Early count of two, but that two was not very long. It is going to take a lot more to bring down either one of these massive dudes.
And what do you say the strategy would be here for these two massive individuals?
I'll tell you my strategy if I'm in the ring, run. That's my strategy.
Absolutely, I would definitely recommend you do that. If by some chance you are not able to get around running away, both men are probably going to attempt to take the other, oh my goodness, probably take the others down by the legs first if I were them. Chop down that tree, the bigger they are, the harder their falls. Anthony Idol doesn't even look fazed by that. As a matter of fact, he looks kind of angry. Simon Miller may want to turn around. Oh my goodness!
Those chops from Anthony Idol are infamous, dude. I've been on the receiving end, and it feels like a heart attack every time that hand hits your chest.
Idol is a definite powerhouse here at SoCal Pro. I'd like to brag and say is homegrown, but that's not true. Entity Idol even started training long before he was here in San Diego, started training up at UPW with some of the older school people that have already been out to the big shows. Big power slam by Entity Idol. Down goes Miller. And up goes Idol. Can he capitalize on this?
This is vintage Idol, dude. Off the second rope. And that is not a good strategy if you want to win your match, having those knuckles bounce off the cranium.
As Simon Miller in an unfavorable position, Entity Idol now with the side headlock, dominating this match as of right now. But again, I say as of right now, both of these men, very talented, very strong, very athletic, an incredible amount of abilities between them two. You got to figure, in this ring right now, we have probably just shy of about 600 pounds.
That is a lot of pounds. That's over 500 pounds, my dude.
You know what? I'm surprised you won a mathematician. I don't know why you got into wrestling. Here's Entity Idol now with the hammerlock to Simon Miller. Interesting strategy, taking apart the arm, back to the head. This is definitely something that Entity Idol is known for. He picks body parts. He wears them down. He doesn't necessarily just slam you all around. He literally will squeeze the blood out of the extremities before he punishes you to the point where Entity Idol is going to take advantage of the pinfall.
And that's the scary thing, my dude. Not only is Idol a powerhouse, he's a downright genius of the ring. Power, smarts, some would say he's got it all.
250 plus pounds is Simon Miller as Entity Idol chucks him over his head like he's yesterday's garbage. Simon Miller may not even know where he is at this point.
California. Trying to help.
You know what? If you just said hi, I think he'd probably know. Snapmare by Entity Idol now. What's going to happen here as Entity Idol hits the ropes? Big boot perhaps to the shoulders of Simon Miller. Can you tell my voice is a little bit hoarse from the last match? This is just two matches in, Charlie.
I'd say mild pony at best, not full horse.
Thank you very much. As Simon Miller presents that jawbreaker, Entity Idol now down.
But as you mentioned, he's been targeting that shoulder, targeting that rotator cuff. It's hard to lift. How big is Idol? If Simon Miller's 250 pounds, got to be in that range. Hard to lift that above your head.
Entity Idol, just over 300 pounds. And just as you say that, one, two, maybe. Just a count of two as Simon Miller picks him up like yesterday's garbage. Both men extraordinarily powerful here. This is like watching two gigantic redwoods go out to battle. You don't even know, how would you even call something like this?
I believe kaiju is the proper term when you see two giant monsters in the ring fighting.
Entity Idol now being worked back to the corner. Big right hands by Simon Miller. That's the third one in a row as Entity Idol doesn't seem to be budging, yet nevertheless is definitely being taken a toll on. Entity Idol goes to the up and over. Simon Miller nowhere to be found. Entity Idol now catching him with a big elbow to the face. Shooting into the ropes, missing that big boot. Simon Miller comes in. Big, gigantic shoulder tackle. And both men are clearly exhausted at this point. You could say all you want to, you could be big and strong, but that you definitely sacrifice a lot of conditioning with that amount of strength.
Big, strong, and at the end of the day, still human, still have a limit. And I have a feeling these two competitors are gonna find that limit.
Simon Miller now looking for the support. He's asking the crowd if he wants to see him go up to the top turnbuckle. I'm not sure if this is a very sound strategy by Simon Miller.
You're asking why? I have a feeling Simon Miller's going to tell you why.
Simon Miller now, big shoulder tackle. That makes a lot of sense. It's Entity Idol now folded up like a lawn chair. I'm not sure if I've never seen anybody do that to Idol before.
Idol's been around over a decade, and I've never seen that before.
Only a count of two. Nevertheless, the Neon Phenomenon has a heart of gold. This man has been through it all. He has been at SoCal Pro for the better half of probably at this point, I'd say 15 years. This man has gone through championships. He's gone through stables. He has gone through an egregious amount of training. You have never seen anybody as strong or have more heart than the Neon Phenomenon. He is not easy to put down, but it says a lot about Simon Miller's ability to come in here and dominate this match as he has been doing. Big elbow now to the gut, and Simon Miller.
continuing to dominate here with a 1-2. Only a count of two, Charlie.
And just like you said, domination, which is not where Anthony Idol is used to being. He's used to being on the other side of domination. He's used to being in control of the match. And it truly seems like the turns have tabled for Anthony Idol.
All right, so it's Anthony Idol is continuing to try to catch up with Simon Miller. Simon Miller, perhaps not the crowd favorite anymore. You can hear this smattering of boos from the audience. Now it's fine to come in here with an incredible heart and intention, but when you go off and you literally make fun of one of their biggest heroes, well, you're in for a lot of a wake-up call from these SoCal Pro passionate fans.
You can have the social media following, you can have the internet presence that Simon Miller has, but even if you're coming from over the pond, dude, you don't mess with the hometown hero, you don't mess with the homegrown favorite.
Homegrown indeed is Mazzy, there it is, improving a point. As Anthony Idol comes back, fouls of fire, look at the anger, look at the determination on his eyes. He might even be busted open here. Anthony Idol is more intense as eyes I've ever seen him. Pushing back Simon Miller. Big spine buster, down goes Simon Miller. And a master of the ups and downs. You best believe that Simon Miller better find his way back up, and he better find it soon, as the Neon Phenomenon may take advantage and win this contest at SoCal Pro.
Anthony Idol may have caught a shot earlier. It looks like the blood's coming from his nose. Nobody makes Anthony Idol bleed his own blood. It's only going to fuel him more.
Anthony Idol now taking advantage of Simon Miller, but no, Simon Miller comes back with a big belly to back, ground to the cover. One, two,
and a half.
Only a count of two, and this speaks volumes for Simon Miller, who has been taking a lot of punishment in the recent moments of this match, yet still able to find all this energy, foster up all this courage to come out after Anthony Idol. He bounces up and down, getting ready to put it to work.
Second rope. Once again, it worked once, it worked twice. If what's working is working, I don't see why you should change, my dude.
Simon Miller is somebody who is definitely methodical in this ring and certainly not necessarily afraid to have some fun with the audience. He's telling everybody, you want to see him go up. This might be a bad predicament for Anthony
Idol. Master of ups.
He goes. No, Anthony Idol tackles down with a big counter. Punch, punch. We've seen this before as we see shades of Dusty Rhodes. And down goes Simon Miller.
Those hips don't lie, and they only spell pain.
This could be it here. The final arrow. Here it is. 1, 2, 3. He got him.
Here is your winner, Anthony Idol.
And let's take a look back one more time at this huge Idol driver by Anthony Idol. Simon Miller, master of ups and downs, but it was he who went up and it was he who went down this evening at SoCal Pro Wrestling Halloween Heat. Of respect from Anthony Idol, offering the handshake of friendship to Simon Miller. To which he accepts. True sportsman here at SoCal Pro Wrestling, and the fans love it. That's what this industry is all about. It's not just the gold. It's not just the records. It's sending the fans home happy, dude, without them. We're just a bunch of sweaty dudes in a squared circle. For the opening bell. The bad blood between these two is going to boil over. It already may have. As the ass-kicking machine, Matthias takes the fight to Tortuga before Tortuga can even get off the ramp. Last man standing match. That means no disqualifications, no pinfall, no countout. It only ends when that last competitor cannot answer the count of 10.
The mighty Tortuga getting his revenge on the devious ass-kicking machine as he takes him out. I didn't even have a chance to announce what the rules of the match were before this match went underway.
But don't worry, I let the folks at home know. Matthias not even letting Tortuga get off the ramp, let alone into the ring to start this contest. But a Tortuga, it already looks like that turtle's gonna fly!
Oh my goodness, as the Tortuga definitely took a chance there, as you see the War Turtle, this new, absolute brand new form of the mighty Tortuga has come into SoCal Pro. New gear, new attitude, new championship belt. If you'll notice, he is the POW MIA champion at Valor Pro Wrestling.
As a matter of fact, I did notice Tortuga 2 belt's gonna fly. Oh
my God!
It is hard to fly when steel bounces off your face. Once again, no disqualifications. Everything is legal in this last man standing match. So that chair shot, perfectly fine, perfectly acceptable means of winning. Let's see it one more time.
Nasty. If these wolves could talk,
the sound that you hear at home didn't even do it justice. It was absolutely thuddening. Oh my gosh!
If the walls could talk, it would be screaming.
As the mighty Tortugo must be doing right now is, as he has, I've never seen Matthias this angry, this fearful, this fearing. Oh my gosh! As Matthias is just the most aggravated I have ever seen him in this contest.
Matthias has one mood, and it is angry. If he's happy, it's still a little scary because he's still mad.
As the mighty Tortuga goes up and down with ease, the mighty Tortuga is getting absolutely manhandled here by the ass-kicking machine, and this crowd could not be any more furious at the contender of this contest.
No more furious at the challenger, but no more behind their champions. SoCal Pro Wrestling, Tortuga's had it on his shell, his shoulders, as he goes toe-to-toe with the ass-kicking machine, Matthias.
Trading back and forth here is mighty Tortuga finally taking some sort of initiative, some sort of advantage in this contest, but all together reversed, up and over goes Tortuga. Matthias charging in, blocked by Tortuga, thumb to the eye, into the buckle as Tortuga goes out. That wasn't even the pad, that was the turnbuckle, the steel. That is what Matthias put the Tortuga's head through just now.
That does not improve your chances of winning, having your skull meet steel. I would actually say it decreases them.
You should be an analyst. You're so good at this. Is Matthias,
I don't know if you can say that on TV.
Is Matthias now taking Tortuga up to the top? What are we going to see here? This is a very dangerous. Oh my God! I heard a crack. I heard the foundation crack underneath them.
Referee needs to check on Tortuga. I saw his dome bounce off of that stage. It has no give. It is wood. It is steel. It is nothing that is soft. One more time, we're going to see it once again.
Look at that head bounce right off of that board. An absolute sick thud. And Tortuga, I have no idea how he even has the energy to come back. As Matthias now grabbing the chair, doing him little to no good as Tortuga taking advantage, grabbing the chair himself. What are we going to see here? Oh my gosh!
Revenge is a dish best served stone cold steel.
As the mighty Tortuga reminding everybody how he is the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion. He is not going to let it go that easily, that is for sure. Listen to this crowd. Again, you can't even hear yourself talk or think.
I can hear what they're saying, and they're calling for one more time.
Tortuga now. Oh, no, caught by Matthias. Boo to the face. Oh, my gosh. And if you ask anybody, the mighty Tortuga is incredibly, an unbelievably nice and compassionate person, but not when it comes to Matthias. Matthias has pushed his buttons. Matthias has gotten something out of Tortuga that we have never seen here at SoCal Pro.
I'll tell you, I have shared the ring with him. I've shared training with Tortuga. He is one of the nicest guys you will ever meet. However, right now, that is one pissed off turtle.
Matthias now back in control, taking the legs from under him. We're gonna see a slingshot to the pole here. Oh my gosh! His face meets steel! Tortuga back now in trouble. Again, this match is one of those matches. It's been like that all night. You can't tell it. You can't make sense of anything. Nobody is ever on top for any long period of time. It's anybody's contest all the time. Ladies and gentlemen, look at this crowd. Look at these people. Listen to the deafening roar. This is SoCal Pro Wrestling.
This is SoCal Pro Wrestling, but this is something brand new we haven't seen this evening. The brutality of this match is unmatched. Nothing has come close to it this evening. The anger, the malice that these competitors feel to each other. Bad vibes all the way around it.
All the way around it. Speaking of bad vibes, here it comes, ladies and gentlemen. We have seen our very first table enter this contest. Mighty Tortuga might be busted
Tortuga,
open
you gotta there. Get up, dude.
In a bad spot as Matthias now setting up this table.
That is bad intentions from that bad man. Bad, just bad.
Oh no, are we gonna see it here? Matthias has done this before, never threw a table. Don't do it, Mathias! Tortuga narrowly escaping. Mathias may be going out. No! If Tortuga had shifted directions, this contest could have been all but over. But I wouldn't even think the tenacity, the ferocious, absolute horrible attitude from Mathias can even bring out the evilness that was needed for Tortuga to put him through that table in that predicament.
Halloween heat under the full moon. The evil's going to come out in all of the competitors, dude.
And look at these people. You can barely even hear yourself talk or think. Tortuga now lifting up Mathias. Could it be? Out he goes!
Mathias tried to stop it, but the power of Tortuga! You were going through that table, my dude, whether you liked it or not. Neither competitor is moving.
They have to stay down for a count of 10, as right now the referee has it at number 3. Look at this one more time. The weight of that table just absolutely being obliterated by the weight of Mathias and the weight of the mighty Tortuga. The referee now at 6. Tortuga's making up to his feet first.
Referee at 7.
Very well, might still be down by the count of 10.
Mathias needs to get to his feet. That's 8.
Mathias is up, and if you look at the back of Mathias, he took the brunt of that table, those splinters, the metal, the wood, just absolutely caving in. Look at the back of Mathias. He has sliced open underneath his right shoulder blade here, Charlie Knarr.
That is one bad laceration that I see on his back.
Oh my God!
But it's not stopping Mathias.
And you gotta figure as Mathias continues to bleed, as he continues to excavate blood outside of that wound. Every time he raises his arms, every time he stretches out his back, it continues to open up that wound. So it must take a great deal of pain to do what Mathias is doing to Tortuga. That is the ferociousness. That is the tenacity. That is the absolute sinister method of Mathias right now. And he is going to do everything he can to walk out with this championship tonight. Unbelievable. Tortuga has been the victim, at the very least, of 4 chair shots that I can count as he gets dumped back into the ring. And now we not only have a table, we have a broken table there, which is all the more dangerous as absolute carnage of wood and metal spikes up. And anybody can be its next victim.
And dude, they are gonna put everything on the line. Blood, sweat, tears, as the blood continues to percolate out of Matthias's back from that table. And now he's going.
Mathias now just absolutely frustrated. What does he have to do to put the mighty Tortuga away? And this is a match right up Matthias's alley, this sinister, evil type of a match.
I've said it before. Brutality, that is what is on the menu. That is what Mathias does. That is all he knows how to dish out. There is nothing but 100 from the word go.
Mathias now pacing back and forth, this feverish, this absolute methodical, sinister son of a bitch as Mathias. Think about his next move, his next play. What is he gonna do now to the mighty Tortuga? What does he have to do to put this turtle away and seal a victory here at Halloween Heat?
I mean, dude, that is one tough turtle, but I don't know anyone who can withstand the punishment that Mathias is putting him through.
Tortuga shot to the buckle, I'll back out.
but that is our SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion, Tortuga, not showing any quit.
Tortuga now with a huge runner. What are we gonna see now? Is Tortuga sizing up Mathias? How does he have the energy? Look at that, that powerhouse back in. We're gonna see it one more time. And he goes. Boom, as Mathias' head bounces off that turnbuckle.
The turtle shell giving him strength adds impact to that maneuver. Cannonball!
Oh, absolute carnage is what we're seeing here at SoCal Pro. Up he goes and down. Mathias might be down. This could be it for the 10 count.
Down goes Tortuga and down stays Mathias. As the referee starts to count to 10.
And you gotta wonder if the Mighty Tortuga has used that move before to put his opponents away. People have stayed down for the count of three. Will they go down for the count of 10? But we're now up to six as the referee gets up to 7. We are almost there, a deep three for Tortuga. But as Matthias now crawls up to his feet.
Oh, but Weeble Wobbly are the legs. I don't know how much more Matthias can take. But Tortuga is going to dish out whatever he can. As he picks up Matthias. And a big slam, as you can see the pain that is going through Matthias's face. Matthias up and then down again. Up and then down again. These two competitors are putting each other through hell, which is apropos for our show today.
Halloween Heat, ladies and gentlemen, nobody does it better than SoCal Pro in Vista. If you are not ever a customer here, if you have never been inside this building, you absolutely have to see this firsthand. This is like no other wrestling that you ever see in Southern California. As now the Mighty Tortuga up to his feet, the first one out to Matthias, delivering that chop, that punch, that chop, another chop now. Tortuga signaling in. Is he going to go back in for another buster as Matthias ducking out of the way, taking all of that weight to the buckles?
And I'll tell you, if you've never been here before and you're not here now, it is standing room only in this building. It is a full house tonight, and it is a full house of pain in that ring right now.
The stakes are high as the winner of the SoCal Pro Rumble later on this evening will be challenging perhaps one of these men for their respective championship. Who's it gonna be? We'll find out here, hopefully in the next few minutes.
Like you said, winner of the SoCal Pro Rumble gets to choose which championship he gets a shot for.
Oh my goodness! That is a tremendous amount of weight down in the center of that ring.
And that is a tremendous amount of force to make that weight bounce like that in the center of that ring.
We have seen a pivotal amount of punishment like we have never seen before here at SoCal Pro. And the absolute tenacity of these two men is like nothing I have ever seen ever in the history of Southern California wrestling.
That alliteration was well-deserved. Pivotal amount of punishment indeed. These two powerhouses.
Tortuga now perhaps to his feet almost as Matthias is up to his feet. Matthias now waiting for Tortuga to turn around, looking to put him away here perhaps. Big right hand goes Matthias.
Big right hand goes Tortuga.
Tortuga is now returning, reciprocating as Matthias and Tortuga go back and forth.
Trading blows in the center of the ring.
Who is going to be the victor here? It looks like Matthias is indeed, at this point, the last man standing. Into the rope, big up and down for the big. Matthias signifying that might be it here, but where's Matthias going? Tell me he's not going now to get more. No, you don't need that. You don't need that.
He doesn't need it, but he doesn't care. He's going to grab it. He's going to use anything he can, grab anything he can to inflict punishment. In fact, he's grabbing one more. What is he?
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
No. No. You evil son of a bitch. You'll
kill the man.
Someone's
got to grab that from him.
He will kill the man.
That's got to be at least a 10-pound sledgehammer that he's throwing around like a matchstick. Oh, my God.
The Mighty Tortuga can't take any more. Oh, my God! Oh, my God, no! Matthias, as evil as a person I've ever seen. How worth it is a championship? You're literally going to end somebody's life over a championship.
I understand that we wanted, I understand that these competitors put everything on the line, but this has gone too far. One more time. Look at the sledgehammer bouncing off the skull of Tortuga.
That is absolutely insane. I have never seen that before.
You saw his legs buckle. I think Tortuga may have been out for a second.
Tortuga, nobody would blame you if you laid down at this point. No man in their right minds can stay up after a count of 10. After taking a sledgehammer to the face, this is absolutely disgusting. The Tortuga is now coming back, but no, absolutely not. There's only so much you can do. All the life has been stripped away from him. I've never seen Tortuga this badly hurt.
I've never seen Tortuga in any situation like this. Matthias is in complete control, and that has no short of a reason to do because of that 10-pound sledgehammer that he brought out earlier.
The mighty Tortuga, an unbelievable amount of valor, I give him that, but it is not worth it. Matthias, just end this match. Just get your belt and go home.
And that may do it.
That might be it, ladies and gentlemen. We might be seeing a changing of the guard here.
So many counts of three have been initiated by that move, but that's not what Matthias needs. He doesn't need a count of three. He needs a count of 10.
There's no possible way Tortuga is going to get away with getting up.
Referee at 6.
I can't believe this.
Not only is he getting up, he's fighting back.
Oh my gosh, how is this even possible? The mighty Tortuga mustering in what sliver of life he has left in him.
And just like you said, he is not going to stop until the tank reaches empty. He is running on fumes. He is running on droplets, but he's still going to keep fighting, and that's why he's champion.
I have never witnessed something like this in my life. If Matthias can't put Tortuga away after all of this punishment, after all of this damage, after all of this carnage, what could it possibly take? Oh my gosh, this Tortuga chucks over Matthias.
You know, I don't know, but I have a feeling we're going to find out. It's Matthias's turn to be staring at the ceiling.
How Matthias is even in this position after all that he dished out to Tortuga is absolutely beyond me.
Referee at a count of 6. 7. Count of 7. Tortuga, watch out.
Oh, no, he has that sledgehammer.
Tortuga, watch out. He's got the hammer again. Tortuga, turn around. No!
Did we just see a double knockout here?
Two different types of steel, two different skulls, both of which bounced off metal meeting bone.
Tortuga and Matthias both in trouble here. This would be such a disappointing end to this match if both men, no definitive answer was had.
Referee at a count of 8. 9, Tortuga's on his feet.
Tortuga!
It's not often you see a match like that. It's not often you see a war like that. 17 years, SoCal Pro Wrestling, I don't think I've ever seen a match as brutal as that one. And I don't think I've ever seen a champion as tenacious as the mighty Tortuga. Between me and my brothers, we got the ground, they're slowing down. It's just-
are just halfway done with this amazing night. We are now going to take a brief 10-minute intermission. Keep in mind, we still have the raffle to go, so this is your last opportunity to get raffle tickets, plus an amazing costume contest. And when we
SoCal Pro Halloween Heat Rumble is underway. Our first two contestants, Don Caliente and Ty Williams, one half of the Shady Boys, one half of Dos Caliente.
The Shady Boys in proud representation here, unfortunately picking a number that is not necessarily advantageous. Nonetheless, Ty Williams in there with the more experience of the two, Don Caliente. However, the more hurt of the two is Don Caliente, a victim of an earlier contest this evening. Ty Williams taking advantage of Don Caliente. In this contest, every person for themselves, you never know what can happen. As far as I'm concerned also, I heard there might be just a few surprises here tonight at SoCal Pro.
A couple surprises, you never know who's going to be an entrant. The numbers drawn, always kept secret, so we don't even know who's in the Rumble, who's gonna be joining, when they're gonna be joining.
Yep, we don't even know, we have no absolute No list, no heads up of any kind about what is going to happen. So we are even very surprised about what happens here. As Ty Williams taking this opportunity to gyrate around as we hear our
Five,
next participants.
4, 3. And our next participant.
Representing the Shady Boys, Remy Morgan.
And what a turn of events. Just like we said, one half of the Shady Boys, we've got Ty Williams and Remy Morgan joining and now tagging. effectively tag teaming against Don Caliente.
The only thing that can save Don Caliente is an ally of his, but again, this is a very interesting contest. There is no friends in this. Even the Shady Boys could turn against each other if they so choose.
If they so choose, but they so ain't choosing. They are working together, bringing the hurt to Don Caliente, who, like you mentioned, already heard it.
Already heard it, indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, the final contest, the main event, the absolute coup de grace of this whole evening is happening right in front of our eyes as Don Caliente, the victim of the Shady Boys, not, however, one bit shy about putting the boots and the work to Don Caliente here. Down he goes, double chokeslam. You know he felt that.
Definitely felt that, but here's the thing. No pinfalls, no submissions. The only way is to win is to throw your opponent over the top rope, and that doesn't work well when they're dead weight in the middle of the ring.
Love it. Absolutely, 100%. And who is this now?
We've got one more entrant coming in. And what a turn of events! It is Don It is Don Caliente's tag team partner, Gustavo Perez. Two tag teams, Shady Boys, Dos Caliente.
What luck is in store right now for Don Caliente, who was all be out of here as Gustavo Perez coming in to make the save. The Shady Boys now have met their matches. Unbelievable here.
Unbelievable here indeed. Tag team action and a double spank. They're showing them who's boss.
Oh, as we have one down from Dos Caliente, one down from the Shady Boys, as we have a go behind now to Ty Williams as Gustavo Perez taking charge here. But Remy Morgan now stepping on the throat of Don Caliente.
As Gustavo Perez tries to eliminate Ty Williams. Big chops from Big Shady.
The Shady Boys now taking the brunt of punishment. I'm surprised that Dos Caliente even has the energy to muster here after their tremendous battle this evening with the Lucha King.
Oh, and a big splash onto the Shady Boys. And one more splash to the Big Shady.
Here it comes, ladies and gentlemen, just a few seconds away from our next entrant. Who is it gonna be?
And a brand new face to SoCal Pro Wrestling making his debut is Zook.
Zook is coming in.
And what a way to make an entrance, a
big cross body. Welcome to SoCal Pro. This young man has it all. Big line now to Remy Morgan. Who's his next one up? Caliente down and out. Remy Morgan now goes for the line. Zook hits the ropes. Head scissors perhaps, down goes Remy Morgan, and Zook is housing this house of fire. This belongs right now to Zook here.
Oh, but the Calientes, no strangers to fire, and how to put it out.
Oh, Zook just cut off there. As you mentioned earlier, Dos Calientes, they have that experience, they have that wherewithal, they are a seasoned tag team here at SoCal Pro. And they're not gonna let anybody come in and mess up their chances. Big chop there by Zook, though.
Zook making his SoCal Pro debut. I've trained with this young man, and those chops, they rival some of the hardest chops thrown by our biggest competitors in SoCal Pro Wrestling. Don't let his size fool you.
And it is a chops aplenty. It is a chop party here by Zook, taking all control. How amazing would this be for this debut of this young man to walk out here as the champion as we get ready for entrant number 5 or entrant number 6. Who is it gonna be?
Entrant number 6. In 3 seconds, we'll find out. The violins can only signal one man. This one man works on his own time. And you know what? He's earned that right, because I do believe it is our Golden State champion, the former Inferno Dragon, Joey Lancaster.
Number 6, the man with the aura, Joey Lancaster.
As you can see, the SoCal Pro Golden State Championship wrapped around his waist.
Jeez, I think it's already time for the next entrance. Look at how much time this man spent here, just sitting there milking his entrance. It's disgusting, this guy.
It's disgusting, the attitude. He turned his back on the fans. He turned his back on the stopwatch. He's turned his back on everything in SoCal Pro. But few can argue the results that it's given him as SoCal Pro Golden State Champion.
Joey Lancaster now going in, dominating this. This is something that is absolutely astonishing to me. This man has no facial expressions. He goes in, he looks like he's pouting every single time. He's one of the most sickening people here. And if anybody here unfortunately has a real shot at winning this battle royal, you guarantee it's gonna be somebody like Joey Lancaster.
Definitely has a shot, definitely has the skill, but does not have the placement. Entering at number 6 out of 25 does not bode well for his chances. The odds are stacked against him.
100% is Joey Lancaster attempting to make every single move count, as he knows that his entrant number does not bode well for him. That nasty use of his feet. Joey Lancaster is probably one of the most sickening yet very methodical. And look, already we have our next entrant on the way.
Number 7 coming in 3 seconds. Taiga Kawasaki coming in, made his SoCal Pro Wrestling debut in last year's SoCal Pro Rumble, where he was thrown unceremoniously by Matthias.
Taiga Kawasaki coming in here with a house of fire. This young man is probably one of the more impressive young people that I've ever seen here at SoCal Pro. We have a ring full of absolute amazing talent, some of the youngest, freshest meat here that we have here. But yet some of the most, more even seasoned people. You have so many people from vast amount of training and experience all coming in here with the same goal in mind, to be the last man in that ring when this is all over.
Working with the speed and ferocity and machine-like precision with such as the motorcycle that he shares his name with, Taiga Kawasaki. Now at the hands of the Shady Boys and Gustavo Perez. On a dangerous position,
Gustavo
might be our first elimination.
That
he's out.
Gone.
Gustavo is our first elimination, and Caliente to follow.
In short order by his tag team partner, Don Caliente.
And this young man couldn't be any happier. Andrew Lancaster, as sick as I've ever seen him. But don't worry, we have somebody to replace them as we get ready for number 8.
Joey Lancaster indeed having that smug smile on his face. But the smile might be wiped off.
Number 8, Dynamite Pegasus!
Dynamite Pegasus coming in like an explosive with those huge drop kicks.
Dynamite Pegasus, another young man that is coming in, making his start here to an incredible journey at SoCal Pro. 100% a future superstar here. And very interesting idea here, going after Joey Lancaster, of all people, is Dynamite Pegasus.
Joey Lancaster has shown that he has a disposition. He hates masks. He's already said he's denounced his. And look there! prying at the mask of Dynamite Pegasus.
Yeah, the sickening.
Despise.
Absolute despise. Yes.
Despise.
Of masks.
He doesn't like them.
He doesn't like them. Thank you very much. And now the Dynamite Pegasus on the opposing side, but now coming back in with Ty Williams. Sadie Boy is not necessarily in a good position here either, as our only remaining tag team at this moment, as we get ready for number 9. Who is it gonna be?
Tornado, a chameleon of SoCal Pro, been a staple here for many years, and always, I call him a chameleon because he always seems to switch up his styles. You can never know what kind of wrestler Blue Tornado is going to be on that night.
Well, we definitely know now. Blue Tornado coming in is obviously not a fan favorite here. I don't know what he expected. He comes in, he starts giving the crowd the business. I'm not sure exactly what his move here is, but it doesn't seem to make a lot of sense.
Doesn't make a lot of sense, but doesn't have to, as he takes down the Golden State champion, Joey Lancaster.
A Blue Tornado, look at it, look at him, look at this. Come on, guy. Oh, Blue Tornado now. Zook is now teaching the Blue Tornado you perhaps shouldn't celebrate too early. Zook now putting the boots to Blue Tornado as
on the other side of the ring, Dynamite Pegasus is suffering at the hands of the Shady Boys. Oh, as he's choking him on the bottom turnbuckle.
Shady Boys definitely working together here at SoCal Pro. Very smart, is the only remaining tag team.
And look at Blue Tornado.
Wait a minute, what is he doing?
He's hiding under the ring.
Did he get eliminated? I didn't hear an elimination.
I don't think he got eliminated. I think he left the ring voluntarily through the middle rope.
As we now get ready for number 10, who is it gonna be?
The war horn sound. I do believe we're being brought to the Highlands.
Number 10, Morgan McClay.
The Highland Berserker making his way to the ring.
Morgan McClay now coming in. This powerhouse. Bring that in, looking like some character from Tekken is Morgan McClay.
Character
with those foot, the feet work of Morgan McClay is absolutely astounding.
Character from Tekken, more like the villain of Braveheart.
The villain of Braveheart, that's a very good way to describe him. As we keep on seeing those hammers to every single opponent, as Zook perhaps goes over the top. Zook hangs in there. Can he stay? Can he come back in?
Oh, here goes! Big boost from Big Shady eliminates Zook.
Zook has been eliminated.
Ending his dreams of winning the SoCal Pro Rumble on his debut.
Remy Morgan and Ty Williams working in tandem here to knock out yet another person. But again, as he leaves, as a door closes, a window opens, as the next entrant, number 11, who is it gonna be?
And clearly fan favorite. The San Diego native Monster Man, his size living up to his name.
Dave Ridgeway now coming in, an absolute powerhouse, and listen to this crowd. It is once again deafening in here. Probably the most popular man to enter. Oh my goodness, down goes Blue Tornado. And they don't call him the Monster Man for nothing, as Dave Ridgeway is a powerhouse to be reckoned with. Nobody can touch this man in terms of size and tenacity, not to mention popularity with the SoCal Pro audience.
Size, tenacity, and training. This man was trained by Seth Rollins at the Black and Brave Wrestling Academy.
Oh, look at this. The Shady Boy's trying to give him a shirt as he wipes his no-no parts with it. Oh, no, and you definitely don't want to do that as Remy Morgan. Oh, no, Remy Morgan's not even, didn't even remotely
Look at this now, Ty Williams, are they crazy? Do they understand who Dave Ridgeway is?
I don't think they do. I think this is their first time stepping in the ring with Dave Ridgeway and...
Almost out of there goes one half of the Shady Boys as Dave Ridgeway goes over to Remy Morgan now.
If he got all of that knee, it would have been game over for Big Shady.
Oh, speaking of which, this could be it. Remy Morgan now being eliminated by Dave Ridgeway coming in as Ty Williams goes out, and out goes Ty Williams!
Ty Williams has been eliminated!
In short order, the Shady Boys have gone back to the darkness of Halloween Heat, back to the locker room, their dreams dashed by the Monster Man. Frankie Flacco is our next entrant making his SoCal Pro debut.
Number 12, Frankie Flacco.
Frankie Flacco, yes, another man coming in. A lot of debuts here. I have also heard we're gonna see a return or two.
That is a lot of heart behind not a lot of mass.
Definitely not a lot of brains. As you will not go after somebody like the Monster Man, but hey, you know what? He's a rookie. He's gonna make mistakes.
I don't mean to laugh, but I'm gonna.
Oh, but nice standing kangaroo drop kick as Dave Ridgeway almost gets taken off his feet.
And
there he goes, taken off his feet.
Harkening back to Dave Ridgeway's mentor, the Sling Blade.
Oh!
And dropped by the forearm of our Golden State champion, Joey Lancaster.
Joey Lancaster, again, showing that dominance inside of this ring. Again, we can't forget the fact that he's in there. He's gonna be in there for a while, guaranteed, unless somebody works together. Beautiful, absolute beautiful, taking down Gary Lancaster. As Frankie Flacco now making a name for himself, Blue Tornado cutting him off. As we hear that sound again, down to six, who's it gonna be? Our next contestant, 3 seconds away.
Number 13, Jake Redondo.
Lucky number 13, Jake Redondo, the second generation sensation, making his way to the ring.
And, folks,
and he's got eyes for one man.
Yep, we know exactly who he's coming for. Oh, but maybe Monster Man is not gonna let him have the satisfaction. Jake Redondo now coming in, taking out some people. Down goes Blue Pegasus.
And that's the danger of the SoCal Pro Rumble.
Flacco now again, every man for himself is Jake Redondo.
Once again, lots of heart, lots of speed, not a lot of brains.
Unbelievable. Jake Redondo now squaring off. We've been waiting for this, ladies and gentlemen. This crowd has gone nuts. The roof has blown off the building as they finally come to blows.
Joey Lancaster looks like he's getting the better of the exchange. Oh, but maybe got too cocky.
Up goes Jake Redondo, down goes Jake Redondo. As Joey Lancaster, again, that man with that experience, the aura as he calls it, yet definitely not a fan favorite here. But we hear that tone and we know what's coming left. Ladies and gentlemen, 5 seconds away from our next entrant.
SoCal Pro debut, Adrienne Diamond, our first female contestant, going toe-to-toe with the Highland Berserker, and coming up,
oh,
and the Monster Man!
As Adrienne, look at
a
this!
A house of fire!
Go, Adrienne!
That is one tough lady who is putting down everyone in her way!
An unbelievable unbelievable turn of events. Our first female. I don't think we've ever seen a female inside of this Rumble before.
History in the making, and what a history-making moment if she comes out the victor.
We are just a little over halfway in, and what we have now is Adrienne Diamond, Blue Tornado, Jake Redondo, Joey Lancaster, Frankie Flacco, Monster Man, Morgan McClay, Dynamite Pia Kawasaki. Ladies and gentlemen, we are just a little over halfway done. Who is going to win this Rumble here tonight?
That's a lot of bodies in the ring, outside the ring, and what a kick by Flacco. Frankie Flacco with a kick to Jake Redondo.
Morgan McClay now going head to head with Adrienne. Oh my goodness, is this fair? She's entered in, it's fair.
Of course it's fair. Did you not see her wreck house? That is a competitor on the level with anyone in that ring right there.
In comes in. We are getting ready, ladies and gentlemen, for number 15. Who is it gonna be?
This is a man that I've got a lot of history with.
Number 15, Andy Hollow.
That is a man I've got a lot of history with, is Andy Hollow.
Andy Hollow seems to be calling some dark forces on his way to the ring. As this man, who you know all too well, the victim of that surfboard that we gave out earlier here, is Andy Hollow. Somebody who has a tremendous amount of heart.
Tremendous amount of heart. Doesn't always use the greatest tactics, but does what he needs to get the job done.
It is just a mishmash as the Monster Man going after McClay. Look at that. And we're seeing people getting worked around here. Andy Hollow now putting the boot to Adrienne. We got the Monster Man working over McClay. Oh my God, who just got out?
I do believe that was Taiga Kawasaki, who just hit the floor.
Taiga Kawasaki has been eliminated.
And look at the carnage we still have left in this ring. Oh, hey, there you go, that might be it.
Frankie Flacco does dangerously dangling over the floor.
Joey Lancaster doing everything he can to get Flacco out of there.
And Morgan McClay over the top rope, but feet have not touched the floor.
Hang on, Morgan McClay, very lucky this man is still in it. No, he's not!
No, he's not! No, he's not!
Morgan McClay has been eliminated.
Unbelievable turn of events, ladies and gentlemen, yet again, we are not here done. Number 16, Charlie, who is it gonna be?
I don't know, but I'm excited to find out.
I'm excited to find out too here.
Hey, what? I think I gotta go.
Oh my God, it's Charlie Noir.
Number 16, Charlie Noir.
Gnarly Charlie Noir making his entrance in. I was thinking he was just gonna be with me tonight. I had no idea this was gonna happen. Unbelievable. Gnarly Charlie Noir, yes sir, do it for us, baby, at the commentator booth. Maybe he could challenge for the tag team championship and we could do it together, who knows? Oh, look, Andy Hollow, Charlie Noir, no strangers to each other. Oh, what's gonna happen here? He ducks in. Oh no, there you go. And there, that's exactly what we thought from Andy Hollow, going after Gnarly Charlie Noir, but Gnarly Charlie Noir answering back. Oh my goodness, and there he goes out of there now.
Frankie Flacco has been eliminated.
Frankie Flacco now out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, we are just down to a few left, but remember, we still have, at this point, 9 more entrants. Gnarly Charlie now going after Adrienne Diamond. Oh, the big forearms to the face. Welcome to SoCal Pro, indeed. Another forearm. You're gonna hear him say I'm sorry after every shot. And we are carving in. Our next participant is slowly approaching. Who is it going to be?
Number 17, Excalibur!
Excalibur making his debut here. Oh my goodness! And what a debut it is! Unbelievable carnage that we are witnessing here. Oh my. And Excalibur is trying his absolute best. Definitely some rookie moves here. Oh my goodness! What is happening here is Andy Hollow now suffering the weight of that mat. Excalibur now going after Lancaster, even in trouble. This is surprising. He's been in there, I believe, perhaps the longest out of everybody. Gnarly Charlie Gnar. Plus, Jake Rodano could not get him in. The carnage here that we have seen is absolutely insane. And ladies and gentlemen, we still have many more to go. Holding on with all his might is Joey Lancaster. CJ. Excalibur now putting the punishment to Joey Lancaster. Big punches now. As all man, Dave Ridgeway now with a bulldog to Jake Rodano. This action is almost too crazy to keep up with. Our next entrant is on the way. Ladies and gentlemen, who is this gonna be?
Number 18, CJ Renegade.
CJ Renegade making his entrance here into the Rumble. A bigger gentleman. He definitely has a lot of potential to win this, as it's definitely harder to get a bigger person out. Using his noggin, that's for sure, against every participant that comes into him. CJ Renegade making his... Oh no, Excalibur is in trouble here. Excalibur might be out. Barely hanging on. As Gnarly Charlie Gnar might even try to be out here. And ladies and gentlemen, the stakes are very high for this one, as the winner of this can challenge any SoCal Pro champion of their choosing. Not a very good position for Diamond Pegasus to be at, but thank goodness he is now down. What are we gonna see next? Who is coming up next? Number 19 on their way. Who is it gonna be?
Number 19!
Vainham, an absolute powerhouse that has been here quite a few times before. Somebody just got eliminated. Who was that?
Adrienne Diamond has been eliminated.
Ladies and gentlemen, our only female in the Battle Royal has been eliminated. We still have, at this point, six more participants. Vainham now taking control. Pegasus up over his head. What is he gonna do here?
Number
look at in the wake of carnage, these men have got to be absolutely exhausted. Gnarly Charlie Gnar now with a nice little cutter. Excalibur still putting the boots down to Joey Lancaster. Vanum now getting worked in the corner as we prepare for number 20. Who is it gonna be? Principal Truman now coming in. Oh my gosh, no. Please eliminate, somebody eliminate him, please. Oh my God, who was that that just got eliminated?
Now it's just Sheep, we're gonna win this whole thing.
CJ Renegade has been eliminated.
Hey, you.
It seems as though that every time somebody comes in, somebody else gets, what is this now? What is he doing? Is he passing out demerits or detention slips? Oh, come on. Oh, that is ridiculous. Good, good, good. Get him out of here. Get him out of here. Oh, big choke slam there by Vanum. As Principal Truman finds out that school is no longer indeed in session. Number 21 making their entrance here in the next 2 seconds. Who's it gonna be? In, no stranger to SoCal Pro and Challenge, Araxio has a very good opportunity here to take this battle royal as we only have 4 more participants to go. Unbelievable, 100%. Ladies and gentlemen, this rumble, this night, this entire Halloween heat has just been absolutely the pinnacle of SoCal Pro thus far in this entire year. The biggest show of the year, without a doubt, bar none, with one of the biggest stakes. Oh, Excalibur almost out of there. Skinning the cat, coming right back in. And look at the look here on Joey Lancaster's face. A disgusting look. Somebody wipe it off of him, please. As our next entrant is just 5 seconds away, who's it gonna be?
Number 22, Gunjack!
Gunjack making his SoCal Pro debut here. Let's see what he can do as he goes straight into Principal Truman, straight into Excalibur. Dave Ridgway looks to be, might be in trouble as Vanum looking to eliminate him, much to the chagrin of this crowd. Araxiel then taking out Gunjack. Vanum now on the opposing side of that monster man, David Ridgway. Gnarly Charlie Gnar has definitely seen some gnarlier days, that is for sure. Excalibur now in not a good position as he jumps up. Out he goes!
Excalibur has been eliminated!
Another night, another elimination. Ladies and gentlemen, Excalibur eliminated by Jake Redondo as we prepare for number 23. Who is it going to be?
Number 23, Latin, Ronnie Thrash!
Rotten Ronnie Thrash making his return here to SoCal Pro.
Gnarly Charlie Gnar has been eliminated.
Well, unfortunately, Gnarly Charlie Gnar is out of there.
What you think about that, baby?
Rotten Ronnie Thrash, ever so excited to come back in to SoCal Pro. Rotten Ronnie Thrash going one-on-one with Dave Ridgway. This could be a mistake on both men. Oh no, big chokeslam coming in for Dave Ridgway. The Monster Man going up and down he goes.
Andrew.
Hey, buddy.
Andrew.
How'd it go?
I didn't win.
Did you win? You didn't win? It's okay. There's always...
What did I miss?
Well, nothing much. There was a rumble. There was a rumble. A couple people came. A couple people left. You were one of the people that left.
Yeah. I didn't win.
That's all right. That's all right. That's okay. You know, you still got... You know, you're number one in my book.
Did I look gnarly?
Oh, you're super gnarly.
That's because it's my name.
Yeah, totally. Totally your name. Yeah. As Vanum now in trouble. Rotten Ronnie Thrash eliminating Vanum. He's out of there.
Vanum not just in trouble. Vanum out of the competition, my dude.
Vanum has been eliminated.
That does not feel good, I can tell you from experience.
Yeah, if anybody knows, it's you. Rotten Ronnie Thrash. Good to see him back in again.
8 years since he's been in a SoCal Pro ring, and I was in there for 8 seconds with him. I'm a legend.
You are a legend. Oh, here he comes.
And speaking of legends.
Anthony Idol.
And speaking of legends, Anthony Idol making his way to the ring, cleaning house, cleaning clocks. Everything's getting clean. It's spotless in there.
Anthony Idol, definitely one of the favorites to win this.
Andrew, I'm sorry, I'm breathing heavy.
No, it's okay. You worked a little harder than me today. That's totally okay. If anybody can wipe that smirk off of Joey Lancaster's face, it's Rotten Ronnie Thrash. His Principal Truman might be out of there.
Right now, Principal
Truman.
He's
out of there.
That's detention, Prince.
Principal Truman has been eliminated.
That's detention. That's a demerit. No gold stars. And
oh,
Gunjack
is eliminated.
Gunjack
is out of there, too.
Gunjack has been eliminated.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is absolutely insane. Anthony Idol now looking to eliminate Araxio, and he's out of there too!
Araxio has been eliminated.
Idol must be a fan of the classics because it is seek and destroy in that ring right now.
Destroy indeed, ladies and gentlemen, as we have just one more entrant to go. Who is it gonna be? 5 seconds away. Here it is, ladies and gentlemen.
And the final entrant, Straight Edge, Eddie Eastline.
Straight from the barrio, ready to inflict pain. The dopest part of the barrio, by the way.
Eddie Eastloss, our final entrant here in this, probably one of the most historical battle royals ever to take place. And look who we have left. We have Eddie Eastloss, Rotten Ronnie Thrash, Anthony Idol, Dave Ridgway, Jake Redondo, Blue Pegasus, and Joey Lancaster, unfortunately. Andy Hollow has apparently been eliminated. We don't need any trouble. We don't need any trouble.
Tranquilo. Peace.
We don't need any. Unbelievable sense of sportsmanship from Andy Hollow. And that's what it's all about here. Every man for himself, 100%.
I knew he was a nice guy.
Nice guy indeed. Oh no,
you know,
Pegasus is out of there.
But not so nice as Dynamite Pegasus being thrown over the top rope.
Dynamite Pegasus has been eliminated.
Dynamite Pegasus definitely going to feel blue after that elimination.
Rotten Ronnie Thrash has been eliminated.
Rotten Ronnie Thrash
Dynamite Pegasus. Did I call him Blue Pegasus? I called him Blue Pegasus.
It's okay. He's feeling blue now. He's out.
That's definitely true. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I apologize. I have been working nonstop. I don't know if you can tell by my voice. This has been an amazing evening. This absolute astonishing event. Dave Ridgeway now slamming down straight edge Eddie Islas.
And it's a good thing he didn't slam him on those detention slips left by Principal Truman. That's not just bodily harm, that's psychological harm.
Psychological harm indeed. As Dave Ridgeway has up Joey Lancaster, what are we gonna see here? Big slam.
And I do believe we are down to our final five participants. Anthony Idol, Monster Man Dave Ridgeway, Joey Lancaster, Eddie Islas, and Jake Redondo.
Anthony Idol, certainly very likely to be the winner of this entire Battle Royal. And if anybody deserves a shot at a championship, I definitely say it would be Anthony Idol.
Oh, absolutely, my dude. He's the freshest in there. He's already had a match tonight, but he's coming in at a cool 23 out of 25. The person who to surprise me most of all, honestly, is Joey Lancaster coming in at number six. He is our earliest entrant and still in the competition right now.
Joey Lancaster, definitely not what I would assume to be favored to be in this ring right now, but nevertheless, give the devil his due. Joey Lancaster definitely sticking it out. As Dave Ridgeway stands above at least three other men here, but be careful because the one other entrant that is currently standing is very, very dangerous. Up goes Jake Redondo and down he goes, the vertical suplex. Joey Lancaster, now look at the smug look on his face. Nope, and Anthony Idol says that ain't gonna way it's work. It's not gonna work that way. Down he goes.
And you know, in all honesty, if someone like Anthony Idol speaks, he usually speaks the truth. Whether it's that way or he makes it that way, but Eddie Islas looking to eliminate Monster Man.
Oh no, what are we gonna see here? Anthony Idol going after Eddie Islas. Eddie Islas barely hanging on. Anthony Idol now just towering over everybody. Again, if anybody has a real good shot at winning this, it would be Anthony Idol.
Not just a good shot, a phenomenal shot.
Unbelievable power and strength by the Neon Phenomenon as the Monster Man goes down to the canvas. Eddie Islas now pushing back. Dave Ridgeway looking for that elimination. But Monster Man is saying no, he still has heart. He's still in it to win it. And there is a lot on the line here, make no mistake about it.
Eliminations were coming hard and fast, a straight downpour of eliminations, and now we've had a drought, haven't seen one. Each of these competitors is not budging in the slightest.
The final five are in there, still in there. It's still anybody's match to win. How amazing would it be if Jake Redondo pulled everything off? If he came in the underdog, to say the least, after a tremendous amount of a losing streak, as it were, to come in here and actually go in and dominate this Rumble, how amazing would that be?
Amazing, astonishing. The A adjectives literally do not end.
Oh, Dave Ridgeway now looking to be a little bit out of gas. Anthony Idol still, I'd say it's still the favorite to win here.
Still, once again, the freshest man in the competition. He had his chance to rest. He had his chance to refuel. And now the big men wearing each other down. Anthony Idol going for that elimination.
Monster Man
over the top rope.
Oh my goodness.
And Anthony Idol.
No, both men hang on.
That was a game of inches right there.
This is still anybody's match. As Anthony Idol and Dave Ridgeway
fighting on the side. That's a big boot by Dave Ridgeway.
The big man goes down.
And Anthony Idol's out. And Dave Ridgeway's out.
Anthony Idol has been eliminated. Monster Man Dave Ridgeway has been eliminated.
Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. And Dave Ridgway, Anthony Idol, still not giving an inch. Oh no, Joey Lancaster! He's out of there! No! No! What?
Jake Crudondo has been eliminated.
I don't think they saw it. I don't think they saw it. He was out. His feet hit the floor. Nobody saw it.
Joey Lancaster hit the floor, but Monster Man and Anthony Idol were not stopping fighting. They had that match last month, and I guess things weren't settled, and now it's cost Jake Crudondo the match.
Like it or not, hooker by crook, Joey Lancaster is in there. One-on-one, ladies and gentlemen, with Eddie Islas. This is unbelievable. This shouldn't even be happening.
Jake, I'm with you, but unfortunately, the referee has the final say, and you've been eliminated. I'm sorry.
It is now down to the final two. Who is going to take it home here? As Joey Lancaster squares off with Eddie Islas, an incredible turn of events.
Incredible, despicable is more like it. Bad vibes.
And we have seen some incredible action here, but it's all gonna come down to the final two, like it or not. Lancaster now getting shot off to the ropes, back to the others. Big back elbow by Eddie Islas.
Eddie Islas is a two-time Golden State champion, and I bet your bottom dollar that he is going to be challenging once again for that Golden State championship if he wins.
Eddie Islas now. Perhaps now with the advantage, could he take advantage here? No,
Eddie
Islas going out.
Over the top rope. Eddie's
hanging
feet.
On. He's hanging on, his feet didn't touch.
His feet didn't touch. Joey thinks he's won it.
Big shoulders to the gut. Eddie Islas now charging in. Up and over, oh no, oh my goodness.
Up and over indeed. As Joey Lancaster hits him with that monstrous driver. What an amazing end to the final show in Vista, California at the Vista Winners Club.
Out he goes!
And Eddie Islas wins! Eddie Islas wins! Tortuga coming out to congratulate his friend. Eddie Islas has just won a title shot of his choosing, and I bet everything I have that it's going to be the Golden State Championship, Joey Lancaster's championship he's after. He's going to make it a three-peat. Eddie Islas has defeated 24 other competitors to win his shot at a championship of his choosing. Greeted by his friend, Tortuga. They've been in the business for years. They've had each other's backs. Absolutely, my dude. Absolutely. Take back what's yours.
Well, I got something else in mind.
Oh my God! Eddie Islas! What just happened? suplex to the, taking the knees to Tortuga.
You have got to be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me.
Eddie. Bad vibes. Andy, I'm sorry. I'm going to steal a word from you. Eddie, you son of a bitch.
Unbelievable. What we have witnessed here is unbelievable. Absolute disgust from this crowd here at SoCal Pro.
I'm sorry I got heated, but it's been a long night. It's been an incredible night. And to wait, and to make it end like this.
Unbelievable. Eddie Islas, you just sealed your fate. You absolute disgusting piece of garbage.
Beach trash, dude. Bad vibes.
A very sad end indeed to Halloween Heat. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have to find out what happens next time at SoCal Pro. Don't miss it. Ladies and gentlemen, join us next time. SoCalProWrestling.com for ticket information. We'll see you next time. Eddie Islas, you absolute piece of garbage.
Why?
Ladies and gentlemen, we will continue this on the time, the next show at SoCal. Please make sure ticket information is at SoCalProWrestling.com for our next event. Do not miss it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming out to Halloween. We'll see you next time.